The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration's, NOAA, Space Weather Prediction Center issued a warning of geomagnetic storm. NOAA models confirmed that a Cannibal CME will strike our planet in December. NASA's findings also suggest that the solar storm could result in vivid auroras in the nighttime sky along with radio blackouts that also occurred earlier this week. NASA warned that the CME is expected to show up a 15-hour-long G2-class solar flare. A powerful M9.8-class solar flare erupted from the Sun on Wednesday, November 29, at 2:50 p.m. EST, hurling a superhot plasma eruption known as a coronal mass ejection toward Earth. The recent eruption, coupled with the multiple CMEs fired off from the Sun on November 27, means geomagnetic storms, disturbances to Earth's magnetic field, are likely. NOAA models confirm that a Cannibal CME will strike our planet on November 30 night and conclude by December 1 early morning. Cannibal CMEs form when a fast CME sweeps up a slower CME ahead of it. The combination contains intense, tangled magnetic fields that can do a good job sparking auroras when they reach Earth. If a Cannibal CME strikes Earth on December 1, as predicted, geomagnetic storm levels could reach Category G3. Coronal mass ejection consists of waves emitted from the Sun that carry highly charged ions that are capable of damaging satellites and communication systems on Earth. These CME ejections possess the potential to blast Earth's magnetosphere with solar energy and excite different gases like oxygen and nitrogen. Earth could experience a strong, G3, geomagnetic storm this week. If so, here's what we can expect. The last G3-class storm on November 5th sparked not only bright auroras, but also deep resaerch arcs around the world. Greg Redfern photographed this example from the Shenandoah National Park in Virginia. This time the northern lights are typically viewed from high latitudes, often confined to Alaska, northern Canada and northern Europe. But during times of heightened solar activity with particularly powerful solar eruptions, it becomes possible to see the aurora borealis much farther south, and the southern lights, or aurora australis, farther north.